Hey, plumbing bros.
Hello, good morning, everybody.
It's fun day, fun last day of 2018.
That's crazy.
I can't believe it.
I can remember when it turned 2000.
I know.
And it was like all the planes were going to fall from the sky. Do you remember that?
I remember that.
Yeah.
Except we didn't fall for that. Everyone was in a panic. I didn't fall for that. All right. Don't follow the herd. All right. So there we have it.
Okay.
Hey, what is it?
Happy New Year's Eve.
Happy New Year.
Yes. Richard Behney, the Million Dollar Plumber.
And the lovely Laura.
Hello. Coming right after you. Coming after you? Gosh, I hope not.
Coming after you. We are coming after you.
We're coming after you.
We're coming after you. If you own a plumbing business.
We are coming after you.
We're coming after you because you are sitting on a gold mine and we want you to succeed. We want 2019 to be the breakout year for you. You just don't own your job.
That's good.
But you have a powerful money-making machine that creates the life. All right, security that you desire for you and your family. Mm-hmm. All right, there's no excuses.
Nope.
Just that you're scared. I'm scared.
Are you digging in the wrong spot?
Yep. All right. So hey, we're coming with you to you with the plumbing business success word of the day is number what?
17, I believe.
17. All right. Mm-hmm. Whatever. 17, which is
ethical.
All right, the big E word.
So what is that for? What does it mean to you to have an ethical plumbing business?
Well, here's how the Million Dollar Plumber looks at it.
You speak in third person.
I'm going to speak in third person. The Million Dollar Plumber would say.
Okay, who else does that?
I don't know.
Somebody, I can't remember. But anyway,
so being ethical, number 17. Plumbing business success word of the day is ethical.
Be ethical.
Number one. All right. Need to be professional. Mm-hmm. Okay.
Not a hack. No hack.
Not a hack in your business. Okay. Mm-hmm. I'm not talking about the plumbing side of thing, but of your business. Okay. So to be ethical with your plumbing business, you need to be professional. You are a licensed plumbing company. All right.
Professional.
So you need to have the look in place. Mm-hmm. All right.
Brand.
A clean brand. Mm-hmm. All right. You need to have the systems in place. None of this fly-by-night paper, you know.
I'll charge this one day, charge this another day, just depending on what I need this week.
Right, rolling up in, you know, into the driveway and open the door and smoke comes flying out of the, you know, and trash falls out and you show up there and, hey, heard you got a plumbing problem. Mm-hmm. Okay, none of that crap. Professional. That's number one with being ethical.
Good, okay.
Number two.
Yes.
All right.
How many do we have?
Three.
Okay.
Okay, I'll make it easy. Okay. There's lots of this kind of stuff. You always kind of make it three easy, just kind of easy. It's easy to just absorb. All right?
Gotcha.
So this isn't rocket science.
Hey, you know what? If you're a plumbing business owner, type CEO in the comments.
All right.
CEO. If you own your plumbing business, type CEO because you are.
You are
a CEO.
A CEO, chief executive officer.
That's right.
All right? You're not a plumber.
Business owner. You're not a plumber. You're
so
a business owner.
You're doing plumbing right now because you got to do it. All right. Mm-hmm. But you are a business owner.
Type CEO in the comments if you own
your
own plumbing business.
There we go.
Yep. Okay.
So number one was being professional, for being ethical. Okay. Number two.
Yep.
All right. Provide options.
Options.
Okay.
That's
giving
so
your
good.
Customer a choice.
Right. I don't understand people that don't do that. Companies that don't provide.
Well,
options.
they're lying to themselves. And really, what you're doing is you're cheating your customer. If you just walk in there and just fix the flapper, just whatever the symptom is, if that's all you're doing. If you're a broke fix plumber, first of all, you're going to starve to death.
You're going to die.
You're going to die. Okay. Or you just, you know, you're telling yourself, well, I'm not going to sell and all that. It's not selling. It's providing your customer options, giving your customer the choice to invest or have the quality of life that they deserve.
Absolutely.
Not what you think is right.
It's not your house.
Right.
You're the professional.
All right. So it is extremely unethical to just walk in there and just fix the problem, just the symptom, and then hand them a bill. Mm-hmm. All right. You're cheating your customer.
Right.
And finally, so there we have it. So with ethical, we have number one is being professional. Number two is providing choices.
Choices.
Number
options.
Three
is.
All right.
What?
Know your price.
What?
Okay. The right price.
I know my price. I know what I need this week.
Not the what you say, the fair price, all that other kind of crap. You're cheating your customer if you don't know what your price is. And by not knowing what your price is, I'm not talking about where you took the price book from the last plumbing company you worked at and take a little bit off, or talking at the supply house and what these guys charge and that guy charged, you know, or you're pulling out of your arse where you're just saying, well, I need this much, this is what I think is fair.
Right.
You're cheating your customer. That is tremendously unethical by behaving like that when you don't know why it is you're charging and what you're charging.
Yep.
All right.
Know your price. That's
so
good.
So know your price. So there you are. To be an ethical plumbing company.
Yep.
All right. To provide an ethical plumbing service. You need to be professional.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Yes.
You need to
do something else. What's number two?
You need to provide options.
Provide options.
And number three, know your price.
Know your price.
So there we have it.
Okay, and tonight we have a special New Year's Eve edition. It'll be 9 p.m. Eastern time because it'll be midnight somewhere, right?
All right, it's midnight somewhere.
Midnight somewhere. 9 p.m. Eastern, it's midnight somewhere. Not sure we'll stay up till midnight or not.
The million-dollar plumber and the lovely Laura need their rest, need their sleep.
Something.
Hey, when you're going all out.
Whoa, sorry. That was
trash in the road. All right.
Trash bag in the road.
Okay.
That was kind of weird. So 9 o'clock Eastern tonight on Facebook, Million Dollar Plumber Facebook page. If you haven't liked the Million Dollar Plumber Facebook page, what's wrong with you?
Right.
Get out there and like it. And you'll get all the notices when we go live. So we'll be doing New Year's Eve special talking about 2019.
And we're going to look into the future.
Or 2019.
We're going to foretell your future.
We are.
Ooh, all right.
Crystal ball.
And we're going to give you...
a year away from being on the eve of 2020.
Right. And we're going to give you the secret on how you can foretell your future.
Ooh.
You can predict your future.
You simply can't miss it.
You can create your future.
With a, what do you call it? Not a tag, with a teaser. With a teaser like
all right,
that.
Teaser. Yeah, so don't miss it. So be there. 9 p.m. Eastern Standard Time.
Yep.
Right here on the Facebook.
Million Dollar Plumber page, to
all
be
right.
exact. So everybody have a great, safe day. Hopefully you're not working. Maybe you took the day off so you have a couple days off in a row. But anyway,
right.
tonight, 9 o'clock, before you get into the big ball dropping and... New Year's rockin' eve and stuff, come and join us on Facebook.
All right.
Okay.
So we'll see you there. Everybody. Other than that, if you are working today, be safe.
I keep cutting
okay.
off.
And as always, you want
plumb
to say
like a champ.
There we go.
Whoop.